Yeah, you actually can, although you're higher in age groups. You can definitely attend this program, don't worry about it. I was just told that the age group is around that, which is 18 to 26. But yeah, you can definitely fill it if you want to. Yeah, don't worry about it.
Ma'am, I have two questions.
Go ahead.
First question is about the organization. So it's asking name of the organization. Is this supposed to be where we are studying or where we are working or which
It
organization?
depends. If you're studying, you can go ahead and put your college or your university. Or if you're working, you can go ahead and put your workplace.
All right. Any preference if we're doing both?
No, it's all up to you.
All right. And ma'am, any specific reason why it's between the age of by till the age of 26? I
I
mean,
have
is
actually
this
added, yeah, I have actually added another thing which says other for
okay?
people who are not in that age group, so don't worry about it. But I was actually told that the entire workshop is for 18 to 26 when I asked them. But it's
Oh,
great if you're not in that age group as well, so don't worry. Yeah.
it still works the same way for us, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
All
Absolutely.
right.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, so I'm going to give you guys another 5 more minutes and then we can start off, and then I'll share my screen. Please put a thumbs up on the chat if you guys are done. That would be great. Thank you, Shruti. Okay, so I'm just going to start off. You guys can take your time maybe after the session to kind of go ahead with that. I hope all of you are able to see my screen.
Yes,
ma'am, we can see it.
All right. Okay. So, okay, first of all, thank you so much, Own Your Growth, which is amazing, whatever you guys do. And thank you so much for, you know, collaborating with us. Just to kind of tell you a little bit about, you know, Mindful Mesmerisms, we are a mental health initiative based in Bangalore. We are basically a group of clinical counseling psychologists and bibliotherapists and language therapists who kind of give, you know, a very holistic approach to a lot of different things with respect to therapy, with respect to, you know, not just physical, but also mental health. Can everyone please mute yourself? Because, yeah, I think that would be great. Okay, so just to kind of give you a little introduction about acceptance and commitment therapy and what this is about. A lot of people have, you know, I'm sure heard about it or maybe not heard about it. It's completely fine. So let's just, you know, start off with what this is and what we do. One second. Okay. So just, you know, to kind of have a basic introduction, the objectives to kind of have, you know, a more understanding of what we're getting into. Now, this is obviously to promote positive body image. Again, when I talk about body image, it doesn't necessarily have to deal with physical appearance, but also mental, you know, how you feel about yourself mentally. Okay. And also, I think the poster said that it's infused with film screening. So we're going to be having, you know, short films, which is about 2 to 3 minutes every session. And yeah, and we're going to have plenty of time to reflect. I would love it if it's, you know, an interactive session, if you all could, you know, interact back with me. And also, we're going to be looking into the core beliefs of ACT, which is what this entire workshop is, you know, all about. So, Okay, so again, just, you know, kind of to introduce, there are 6 sessions, as I think the poster already mentioned. Each session, as you can see, has a different theme. So there's being present, there's cognitive diffusion, there's acceptance, values, self as context, and committed action. Now, all of these sound probably a little confusing, but don't worry about it, because we're going to go step by step. Okay, and this is a journey. So, you know, maybe the first step might not make a lot of sense to you, but I'm sure as we go on with the journey, a lot of different things would definitely make sense, right? So coming, you know, to being present, okay, again, you know, kind of putting that into a very psychological perspective, these are basically the core beliefs of ACT, which is, you know, what each session deals with. Now, since we know the first session is being present, so just want to know what you guys think. What does being present mean to you? So you can unmute yourself and, you know, speak up if you want to, or you can, you know, probably put it up in the chat if you're more comfortable. I would love to know what you guys think about, you know, what being present means to you. Okay. Yeah. Also, for any of you who haven't completed the little questionnaire, you can go ahead and complete it later on. Don't worry about it. You can save the link if you want to. Yeah, and the responses will be kind of shut by the end of today. So don't worry. Okay. So yeah, what does being present mean to you? You can, you know, unmute yourself if you want to share anything as well. Living in the now, absolutely. Thank you so much for that. living in the now.
Your presence of mind in the present.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Also, please don't worry. There are no right or wrong answers. There are no silly questions or silly answers. So you can be completely free. And thank you so much, Ruti, for that. Absolutely. You know, that's right. Being conscious about what you're doing. Yeah. Not dwelling in the past to the future. Absolutely. Yeah. But actually being present, you know, both physically and mentally, you know. So, yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, to me, being present is also actually just being okay with whatever is the current status, being in acceptance of that.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Whatever is happening, I mean, doesn't mean everything is going fine or things are favorable. Just acknowledging things and being okay, not fighting with it.
Okay, there's something that's echoing. Yeah, thank you so much, you know, for that. So true, actually accepting and acknowledging what we're going through currently. Also, there's quite a few people on the chat. Being mindful of everything around us, yes. Being mindful about things running in my mind, not worrying about the past or the future and focusing in the now, on the now. Absolutely, thank you so much. So, yeah, that's actually very true. You know, being present actually means being here and now, right? And being fully able to enjoy the moment that you are in. It's basically just being present in the moment. You know, how many times are we present physically and mentally, right? A lot of times we are not present mentally, where sometimes, you know, our minds are wandering mentally and we're not really, you know, thinking a lot of, you know, we're probably thinking about a lot of different things. I'm sure even now, you know, we're thinking about a lot of different things that's in our mind, and we're probably present physically, virtually in the meeting, but, you know, probably mentally we're somewhere else, and sometimes we're mentally present but physically not present, which is what COVID has done to us right now. But thank you so much, you know, for sharing your thoughts. Okay, moving on. You know, so just three questions. I would love to know what you guys think in the chat. So I think unmuting yourself and talking is a little inconvenient, but please go ahead and you can, create chaos in the chat. So what are you feeling right now? Okay, three questions. Why are you feeling that way? And what triggered that feeling? Okay, so just to give you an example, for me, I'm feeling hungry. Okay, why am I feeling that way? Because I haven't had food. And what triggered that feeling? The fact that I absolutely love food, and that is one of my biggest trigger points for me, just food lying around. So that's what I'm feeling. So you can feel anything, maybe feeling happy or disappointed, or, you know, it can be both negative and positive. So I would love to know what you guys are feeling. Okay, a little anxious, should be doing something else. But I'm here because I like the subject. Okay, I'm glad that you chose this. I hope that it's going to help you in, you know, any way possible. Thank you so much for that. Please don't be anxious. Please be excited. Okay. So, yeah, just, you know, three questions. What are you feeling? Why are you feeling that way? And what triggered that feeling? Or where do you think this feeling originated from? Because we're talking about the present, it's so important to understand what we're feeling right now. And as I think someone rightly said, acknowledging and accepting that we're feeling a certain way. Okay, it's okay to feel anxious, it's okay to feel negative. Okay, but as long as we're accepting and acknowledging it, I think that makes more sense, right? So, yeah. Anyone else? Okay. Hopeful just started a new journey, got a call from a friend. That's great. Thank you so much. Try to understand and analyze what this topic means to me. Don't worry, we'll get that together, Shruti. Don't worry, okay? Feeling curious. I haven't heard about ACT before. What triggered it? Okay, I think being curious is quite fundamental, and to all human beings, wanting to know and learn more. Absolutely. Thank you so much for this amazing curiosity. So I think ACT in itself is acceptance and commitment therapy, which I think is very, you know, not probably simple, but, you know, it sounds simple, but it's quite a long process. It's, you know, accepting and not tolerating, you know, and it's committing to who you are or who you want to be, right? Feeling a little lazy, I feel you, man. Yeah. I didn't have my everything coffee. Oh, wow. Okay. Wanting to have that hit coffee. Yeah. I really hope you get evening coffee. Okay. Okay. So I really hope you get your coffee after this session. Don't worry. Hot coffee. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So thank you so much, you know, for sharing that. Okay. Will 60s be enough to learn the basics of it? Absolutely, because so a lot of people actually just have one entire session for all these six things, but I kind of thought about it and I'm like, no, I think that's too much. I think we should really have one day for each of these sessions. So yeah, I'm sure we would be definitely able to cover all of it and also have practical learning experiences because that's what we're all about. Okay, exhausted, no break since 15 days. So physically exhausted and mentally a little drained. I hope that this helps you feel a little better. I feel you. I think we're all exhausted with this whole COVID and all of that. So yeah. I love this enthusiasm. Thank you. Please keep up the enthusiasm. Okay, we're going to move on. Okay, thank you so much for your responses. You can keep pouring it in if you have anything else to say. Multiple feelings at the same time. Yeah, I feel you. Yeah. I'm so glad that, you know, all of this is so relevant because we're all feeling so many things at the same time. It would be great if you could please mute yourselves. Okay, just a gentle reminder. Okay, so I hope you can see the image on your screen. Okay, I'm sorry about this chaos at the back. There's some construction going on. I don't even know why, but yeah. Okay, so, you know, just kind of understanding what we feel, or, you know, maybe you could kind of tell me, when was the last time you felt mindful, which is the second mindful? Because a lot of times we feel the first mindful, which is the fact that our mind is so full of so many things, it's chaotic. And sometimes it's good. It's good to stay busy, but not at the, you know, cost of being exhausted. You know, as some of you just said, multiple feelings at, you know, the same time, exhausted, mentally drained out. Yeah, that's because, you know, our minds are so full of so many different things, which is sometimes okay because, you know, our work might expect that from us, or our, you know, academics might expect that from us, just to kind of multitask all the time. And it's crazy, right? As human beings, we're so great at multitasking, but we have forgotten how to just stay existent with ourselves and with, you know, things around us, right? So when was the last time when you felt mindful? Okay, which is the second mindful, of course. So just, you know, want to know. Last night, which is great because I've heard a lot of people say last year and a year, you know, a few years ago, which is crazy. So last night, great. Thank you. If you could just share what you did, you know, last night, or what made you feel that. Okay. See, yeah, I was just coming to that. I don't remember the last time I felt mindful. Yeah, absolutely. This noon, that's amazing. Few minutes ago, I love this crowd. Okay, so many people I've worked with don't remember when was the last time they felt mindful. Yeah, you know, listening to a podcast, this is great. Okay, I think half my work is already done. Okay, don't remember. Okay. Yeah, you know, and I'm sure because sometimes we don't remember because we're so full of so many different things, right? If you can just see in the picture, we are actually, you know, full of so many different things. Like if we're working women or if we're students, you know, what do you think is going to happen in, you know, at work or in college tomorrow? Or what do you think my friend is going to say? Or what do you think my partner is going to say if you guys are married or in a relationship, or, you know, if you're single, which is still great. Okay. So yeah, you know, just want to kind of, or maybe if you don't want to share, it's okay. But, you know, think about when was the last time you guys were mindful, the second mindful. I'm sure we're all, mindful, the first one right now and a lot of times. But think about when was the last time you guys were, you know, really mindful of your present, of your existence. You know, when was the last time we just were breathing and existing, right? We have forgotten to consciously breathe, I feel sometimes, because we're so full of so many different things, right? So yeah, thank you so much for sharing. I'm just going to move on. Yeah. Okay. So when I say here and now, what is the first thing that pops in your mind? Okay. Oh, wow. Skincare regime at night makes me feel relaxed. That's amazing. So that thing makes me focus and makes me feel good. That's amazing. And I hope you continue kind of doing that on a daily basis. I hope that's consistent. So thank you so much for sharing that. During a walk in the greenery with my dad. Oh, wow. I would really love some greenery right now. And I would really love, you know, COVID to kind of just end, to just, you know, get lost in some forest. But yeah, life is not easy. But yeah, okay. So when I say here and now, what is the first thing that pops in your mind? Okay. So again, I would love to know your responses in the chat. And thank you so much for making this so interactive. I absolutely love the interaction. It's great because this session wouldn't be possible if there was no interaction. And I don't believe in monologues. So yeah. Here and now, breathing, senses, absolutely. When I learn something new from any source, so does that mean here and now, or does that mean when you are mindful, Jyoti? Can you please clarify that? Okay, and thank you, yeah. Social media, okay. 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 Where I am, like, I'm here in this meeting and following that, what you are saying, not in the past experience, nor what ifs of the future. Okay. Here in my clinic, I'm attending the session, took the time out. For this what? What is SP? That I could do something for myself? Absolutely. I think we all need time for ourselves. So thank you. Like, yeah, okay, like here too, like being my being here and now. Okay. During evening guided meditation. Okay. Session. Okay, thank you so much. Yeah. People from different places. Yeah. Yeah. So here and now, basically, thank you so much for giving your amazingly creative answers. Here and now basically just means be here and be now. Okay. As fundamental and primary as it sounds, a lot of times we overthink and we forget that, you know, the simplest of things can be the correct answer. Okay. So being here and now just means being here and being now. Okay. But thank you so much for, you know, your responses. It's been absolutely great. Okay. Okay. So I'm just going to start playing the video. I hope that it's audible and there is no lag. Okay. Okay. So these are, so just to give you an introduction, these are short animated films, which talks a lot about metaphors. It can be open to interpretation. Again, there's no wrong interpretation. Please feel free to interpret as, you know, however you want. Okay. You can write down notes if you want to, as to whatever you learned as well. So yeah. Is everyone able to see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm just going to start playing.
And then she tries to bring herself up with some makeup. Get over it. We all know what you are. Hi, Gina. Wow, Kat, you should probably clean up that mess on your face.
Nice try. Ugh.
I told you to get rid of those fugly skates.
Oh, no, yeah, I'm gonna get rid of them today.
Good, because they were sticking up the hallway.
Beep, beep.
to get rid of those fugly stains.
They were sticking up the hallway.
Okay, so I hope you guys were able to understand a little bit from the video. So I would love to know your thoughts. Please feel free to kind of just put it up in the chat, and we can kind of, you know, continue from there. Okay, were all of you able to understand what was happening in the short film? Or was there a lag or something, just to kind of ensure? Thank you. Okay. She was about to give up on something that she likes just because people laugh at her. You know, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. And you know, how many times have we kind of done that, right? Sometimes our parents or our loved ones would tell us, hey, like, you know, sometimes things won't work out for you. But, and how many times have we listened to them, right? How many times have we believed them? Right. So if you would have noticed, her reflection was following her, just to kind of, you know, give you a little perspective. Yeah, stuck and free. I think that's, that kind of says it all. Thank you. Yeah. Don't leave something that makes you happy for impressing someone. Absolutely. Thank you so much for that. Absolutely. Right. Because that's so important. I think we've been doing that all our life. Right. You know, trying to get involved, trying to fit in because you know, somebody else wants us to feel a certain way. So thank you so much for that. Okay. Okay. There's, okay. I kind of missed a few things. My bad. Okay. Trying to fit in someone else's concept of perfect, the inner voice makes us realize what we actually want to do. Absolutely. That's what her reflection was, right? That's what her reflection was trying to do. You know, trying to make her understand that you don't have to be a certain way to fit in, you know? Yeah, which we can overcome because we are in charge of our lives. Absolutely. Yeah, kind of similar to man and the sick donkey story. Oh yeah, now that you've put that in my mind. Yeah, never thought of that. So thank you so much for sharing that. Yeah, you know, the whole concept of log kya kahenge has been so instilled in our mind sometimes that we sometimes forget what we want to do with our lives, right? And I think what Kanika said here is that that we are in charge of our lives, which is so absolutely true because, you know, but the problem is if we won't believe it, you know, who else is going to believe it, right? Okay, so basically she's trying to feel comfortable of seeing herself, making peace with herself. Yeah, absolutely. She underestimated herself and then she understood her happiness. Yeah, and I think a lot of times we forget that our happiness does not have to depend on other people, right? And I know it sounds very idealistic and I know it sounds very hypothetical and it's easier said than done sometimes, but hey, you know, we can start from somewhere, you know, and it's good that we want to start from, you know, wherever we are right now. Okay, somewhere we got stuck in traffic, okay, and we find ourselves as victims instead of just, okay, we want to be and start doing as they think that we're supposed to be doing. Absolutely. Yeah, I think I understand what you're trying to say. Yeah, I think society is sometimes traffic, right? It tells us when to go, it tells us when to stop. So instead of traffic, I think it should be traffic lights, because yeah, but then, you know, people also don't listen to traffic lights today because it's India. But yeah, I completely understand what you're, you know, trying to get at, the fact that we are directed by society today, right? But how does that make us feel? You know, does that make us feel smothered? Does that make us feel suffocated? Does that make us feel liberated sometimes? You know, so important that we feel liberated, right, in whatever we do. So thank you so much, you know, for all of this. These videos are available on YouTube, and we will be having, you know, kind of just a couple of minutes for reflection understanding why, you know, what the video is trying to tell us, and also how we can interpret it into real life situations. Okay, so thank you so much for all of this. Okay. Okay. So, just, you know, another question out to you. What, according to you, is self-reflection? Okay, so it can mean different things. For me, self-reflection is, you know, how when I look at myself. So initially, I used to feel that, okay, like I'm short and I'm fat and I, you know, don't have a lot of hair and, you know, I don't look very good. So I used to feel that way, okay, a long time ago. And then it took me quite some time to look at myself and say that, hey, like, I'm young and I'm doing PhD and, you know, find another person who's doing what I'm doing, you know. So, yeah, you know, nobody else is doing what you're doing. Nobody else has been through what you have been through, okay. Nobody else is going through your journey. And I really hope that we, you know, understand that and internalize that as much as we can, because that's what makes us who we are, right? Okay, there's more comments. Yes. We internalize the judging comments and beat ourselves up. Absolutely. Yeah, you know, and that's the worst part, right? We beat ourselves up because we choose to be beaten up, right? Imagine if we didn't choose to be beaten up at all. We would be liberated. We wouldn't really care about what other people told us, whether it's derogatory or whether it's, you know, harming our self-esteem, right? Self-reflection depends on what we identify ourselves with. Absolutely. 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 It can be physical, it can be mental, it can be emotional, it can be so many different things, right? So, yeah. Okay. Thank you for that. Okay. Moving on. So just, you know, another question out to you guys. Do you think self-reflection is equivalent to being present? Or do you think they're, you know, absolutely different concepts altogether? So what do you think, you know, about that? Okay, there's quite a few chats. Okay.
Can you please repeat the question?
Okay, so am I audible? Is there a lag or something?
Yes, you're audible.
Okay. So just, you know, another question is that, do you think self-reflection is equivalent to being present? Because we just spoke about being present and, you know, we spoke about reflection. Do you think it's equivalent to that, or do you think they're absolutely different concepts, you know, altogether? Different? Okay. Can you tell me how different they are? Okay, wow, this is
this self-reflection comes out from your own thoughts and the mental perceptions that you gain from what you see. Our being in present is your presence of mind. You're not having any thoughts.
Right. I think that makes so much sense. But, you know, just to kind of give you, you know, a different perspective on things. So I think a few of you have said that it is the same, and it is not completely same, but it is related. Okay, so just to kind of give you a very basic explanation, right? Okay, means witnessing. I would love to know what you mean by that. Thank you so much for that. Okay, reflecting on our thoughts, perspectives, and attitudes. Absolutely, absolutely. Introspection also means being present. When you're introspecting, which is basically self-reflection, it also means, what are you going through? How was your day? What are you feeling right now? You know, are you really present in that moment? What is, you know, happening around you? As we kind of, you know, looked at it earlier, that being present also means being present mentally, right? Not just physically, because that's what we're more, you know, focused on right now, being present mentally. So self-reflection, when you introspect, or, you know, or a very basic thing could be, you know, when you look at yourself in the mirror. I'm sure with COVID going on, you would look at yourself in the mirror, and obviously grooming is not a big priority in the past 2 years because of the lockdown and, you know, all of that happening, and online classes or work from home and all of that. So, you know, have you kind of looked at yourself in the mirror and just realized, oh my God, I have put on, or I have lost a little weight, right? and I need to kind of probably start eating more or stop eating more or, you know, whatever. But, you know, when you look at yourself, so I looked at myself in the mirror after so many months, actually looked at myself, and I'm like, oh my God, there's a pimple on my face, which was not there before. And I kind of freaked out. And you kind of somewhere realize that, wow, like times are changing, but we haven't even had time to actually look at ourselves, you know, whether it's physical or mental, right? How many times do we actually, you know, truthfully look at ourselves, honestly, you know, without judging ourselves, right? Because a lot of times we look at ourselves, we start off with so many judgments, you know? So yeah, that's what, you know, just kind of putting that into perspective. But yeah, something that you can definitely think about, you know, that these are a few introspective questions, you know, thoughtful questions that you can definitely take back and think about. Okay. So I know too many questions, but I love that you guys are being super, you know, interactive. Okay, just another thing, what does being present in your body mean to you? So if you're not comfortable, you can share it personally with me in the chat. Or if you are comfortable and if you don't mind sharing, you can definitely put it up in the chat. Or if you don't mind, you know, unmuting yourself and sharing, you can definitely do that too. But if you don't want to share, it's fine. Okay. Orgasm. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Okay. Yeah, thank you so much for sharing that, you know, with absolute honesty. Okay, thank you. Okay, so what does being, yeah, someone saying something, sorry.
May I?
Sorry?
Yeah, present in the body, I mean, in my understanding, it is about identifying with what is happening in the body, just being able to observe what's happening. For example, if I have racing thoughts if I have palpitations, identifying that and not, you know, being aware of that, aware of what's happening.
Absolutely.
What are the sensations in my stomach? How am I feeling in my head right now? Do I have tightness? Do I feel free?
Yeah.
Sometimes when we are so caught up in some thoughts which are not very good. There's a lot of tightness in the head. So being aware of what our body is trying to tell us, being present in the body.
Absolutely. So true. Because I'm assuming you're a medical professional. With all the terms that you use, but thank you so much for sharing that, because that puts a lot into perspective. And we do have a few chats. Not wanting to be someone else, but being okay with your body. Absolutely. So accepting your body is also one of the sessions, which is our third session, which we will have on Wednesday. And we will definitely look into more about what acceptance really means. So yeah, absolutely. Listening to what your body is trying to tell you. Yeah, you know, how many times do we actually listen to what our body is trying to tell us, right? Or how many times do we actually listen to what we're feeling, right? I think as someone who rightly said, you know, understanding and, you know, being aware of whether we're having palpitations or breathlessness or whatever, a lot of times we feel that, okay, this might just be situational. It's okay. Maybe it's not. Maybe your body is actually trying to tell you something, right? So thank you so much for that. Being aware of my body physically and mentally and accepting it for what it is. Yes. So as I said, we will have a session on acceptance and what it really means. And I'm sure it will bust a lot of myths that we have about what acceptance really means. But yeah, thank you so much. So I'm just going to move on. Okay. So this is called the art of being present. This is not just theoretical, but also very practical, something that you can definitely take back, you know, after the session. You can sometimes practice it as well if this is something that works for you. And okay. So you have activities, routines, and triggers, which is basically, you know, the art of being present. Activities is basically, choose an activity that makes you happy. Okay, that's what activities basically means here. Choosing an activity that just makes you happy. Okay, so it can be any activity. It can be, you know, cycling, or it can be cooking, or for me, it is solo traveling. Okay, that's something that absolutely makes me liberated and autonomous and free. And so I have my car. I just randomly take my car and my backpack and spontaneously just go if I'm like, if I think that I can't take it anymore. Okay, so yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay, thank you so much, Jyoti, for sharing that. You know, thank you. Okay, and I'm sure, you know, that we're aware of this, which is great, because now we know what to work on. Because if we're not aware of it, we won't even know what to work on, right? So yeah, so that is activities. Kind of choose something that makes you happy. Okay, and then routines, you know, making that into a regular thing. So if something makes you happy, why don't you do it regularly? Maybe not every day, you know, or maybe not twice a day, or just very frequently, but maybe just do it regularly, right? Like if painting works for a lot of people, you know, dance works for a lot of people, it helps them express themselves. So making that into a routine, right? And again, you know, a lot of people have told me that when we start making things into a routine, it becomes stagnated after a point of time. And I'm sure you guys would relate with that. But hey, if that makes you happy, you'll never be stagnated, right? If that doesn't make you happy, that's when you'll feel stagnated. Okay, so maybe think about that. Yeah. And triggers. Triggers is basically understanding why certain things make you feel happy or sad or angry or, you know, annoyed. Okay. And it's so important to understand why we feel what we feel. Because if we don't understand why certain things make us happy, we would have never started doing that, you know? Or, you know, if we wouldn't have known what made us sad or why we feel sad because of certain things, we would have never known, you know, why, you know, if this made us sad or angry or whatever else, okay? So it's so important to understand why we feel what we feel, okay? And kind of putting that all together is the art of being present. So when you have activities, you have something called flow, which is basically you do something that you love and then you kind of just sometimes lose track of time, right? Like I know a lot of people who just absolutely love their work and who would not even regret going sleepless nights because they absolutely love what they do, right? And that's amazing because like I want to be that person, you know? I want to love my work so much that I don't even care if I'm not getting sleep, but I'm actually doing something that's so productive. Right, but no, please get sleep. Okay, please don't find something that you lose sleep on. Please get sleep. Okay, please go ahead, Samyaka. Please go ahead. Okay, don't worry about it. Okay, yeah, so this is basically the art of being present. Okay, and I hope this is something that you know helps you guys in any way possible. Okay, moving on. So just to kind of conclude, okay, also, we do have a feedback form that will be shared in the chat, and we will be giving you guys about 5 to 10 minutes for everyone. So you guys can fill that up, okay, before you leave. And yeah, okay. So, okay, being present, okay. So being present in your body is the best present that you can ever hope to receive from yourself. You know, don't you agree with that? Because I think if you are present in your own body, I think that's the best present that you can ever receive, right? You know? Sorry. Okay. And you know, when we're present, our speech, facial expressions, posture, and movements align. They synchronize and they focus, and that internal convergence is that harmony is so powerful and resonant because it is real, right? And a lot of times, you know, just to kind of put that into perspective, a lot of times we might feel happy, we might feel angry inside, but I think because of society, we're supposed to put that mask of smile on our face, you know, whether it's work or whether it's college sometimes, that we're always supposed to put, you know, a mask of smile and tell everybody that, hey, everything's fine, nothing's wrong. But hey, no, if something's wrong, please tell people something is wrong, you know, and if it's important, please tell them, right? So when we are happy on the inside, it's automatically going to show on the outside, because that's how resonant our body and our mind is, okay? So important for us to be happy on the inside, right? And if we're feeling angry, please express it, you know, positively, of course, but please express it, and please don't pile up, and please don't bottle up your emotions, because that's just going to cause more problems. And I think as mental health professionals, we have been kind of saying that to so many people, it's okay if you feel a certain way. It's okay if you feel angry. It's very normal. Okay. And the fact that society sometimes tell you that, hey, don't feel angry, it's not okay to feel angry. No, it's absolutely okay to feel angry or sad. These are universal emotions that we all go through, right? But please express it, you know, in positive ways. Please don't hurt anybody, or please don't hurt yourself, but please express it in positive ways, right? So just to kind of put that into, you know, perspective, that how our mind and our body is so connected. Okay, after all, face is the index of the mind. Yes, absolutely. That's absolutely true. Thank you so much for that. How to express anger positively. So a lot of people that I work with, journaling is something that helps them. You know, if you have anger issues, you can journal, you can write about it. Or sometimes something that has helped a few of my clients is just write about it or scribble it and then tear it and then throw it and then just breathe. Okay. And if you're angry, take a few minutes to just breathe. Sometimes it's impossible to hold water in your mouth, which is something that a lot of people keep saying. But breathe. Please don't forget to breathe. You know, sometimes it's important to understand why we're angry. Okay. So that's some of the ways. I hope that helps. Okay. Okay. And finally, just, you know, a last thing that I want to leave you guys with is that your body is present, right? I'm sorry. But where is your mind? You know, where do you think your mind is? Is your mind in the present, or is it in the past, or is it, you know, in the future? Are we too, you know, worried about our future, or are we too, you know, are we delving too much on the past, or are we in the present with our body, right? So maybe just think about it. You know, you don't have to answer if you don't want to, but something to just probably take back, think about it, and yeah, you know, something to just introspect on. Okay, so this was our first session. Okay, so I'm just gonna put the feedback link. Okay. Yeah, so I've just put the feedback link. Please feel free. If you didn't like something, please let me know. Okay, please be completely honest. So I think we are out of time, but you can definitely, you know, fill the feedback form. Moderator, do we have 5-10 minutes to give them so that they can fill up the feedback form? Moderator has muted himself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So we have about 5-10 minutes. You guys can take 5-10 minutes and fill the feedback form. And yeah, any questions, anything else that you would like me to address, please do let me know. You can put it up in the chat, or you can actually feel free to ask any questions that you have right now. I would love to take any questions that you have.
Yeah, everyone unmute themselves or put the questions on a chat box if they have any. Ma'am, you are muted. We cannot hear you.
I'm so sorry. So it's only till 30, you're saying. So I'll just add another option. Don't worry. Okay, so I've just added another option. So don't worry if you're, if you're 22, then it's there. No, 80. Thank you for pointing that out. I completely did not think about that. Yeah. Okay, so I have added that. I'm so sorry. Thank you so much for pointing that out. Yeah. What will our takeaways, sorry, after these sessions? So, you know, your takeaways are completely up to you. Okay, so a few takeaways was the art of being present, which is something that you can kind of, you know, really look into after the session. Also, you know, since it's our first session, something that you guys can just think about, you know, a lot of questions were kind of asked, introspective questions, maybe just think about them, you know, and probably get back to me if you, you know, think about something or if you want to share something, you know. Yeah. Okay. Also, if there's anything else, would love to know what you guys think in the feedback. Okay. So a lot of people don't use films in workshops. And, you know, usually when they use films, it's just for either entertainment or just viewership. But I think the whole point of films today has changed a lot because nobody talks about how we feel about it, you know, but people talk about how it's entertaining us. So yeah, so just want to give you a little different perspective on how films are really helping us. So yeah. Any other questions, anything else that you, you know, you want to ask or want to suggest or advice so we can better in our next session? Would love to know your responses. Yeah.
I think, ma'am, there are no further questions we have in the chat box as well, and no one is unmuting.
Sure. So I've just shared the feedback form. If you guys could just fill the feedback form, or maybe, you know, you can, after filling the feedback form, you can leave, okay? You can leave the meeting. So, yeah. Thank you so much. And I will see you guys tomorrow.
Sure, ma'am. It was a wonderful session and lovely talking with you, ma'am. So I think everyone has enjoyed the session first day, and we hope to continue tomorrow at the same time. Everyone, I request that please join again and tomorrow. So it is a 6-day session and do not miss this opportunity to learn and grow, as the certificate will be only provided to the participants who attend daily sessions. So thank you so much everyone for joining today, and we will continue the session tomorrow. And once again, thank you so much, ma'am, for your time.